On behalf of President and Mrs. William R. Harvey, I welcome you. My name is O'Shea Moore. I'm a fourth-year, five-year MBA major from Prince George's County, Maryland, and I have the distinct honor of serving as your hostess for the 2020-2021 Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant.
My name is Marcus Anderson. I'm a graduating senior business management major from Laurel, Maryland, and O'Shea and I are glad to serve as your host and hostess for the 2020-2021 Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant.
We have eight extraordinary contestants competing for the Miss Hampton University crown and for the distinct honor of serving as ambassador to our great institution for the 2020-2021 school year.
Contestant number one, Anasia Bailey.
Contestant number two, Keandra Howard.
Contestant number three, Julianne Jamont.
Contestant number four, Angelica Johnson.
Contestant number five, Olivia Johnson.
Contestant number six, Kayla Jordan.
Contestant number seven, Christian Peterson.
Contestant number eight, Laren Turner.
Now, as you can see, our contestants are oh so lovely. Now, essential to this pageant are our judges. Let us thank and applaud all of our judges for their time and expertise in choosing the best contestant for the position of Miss Hampton University.
Miss Brent Michelle Martin. Miss Brent Michelle Martin is currently the Director of Alumni Affairs at Hampton University and is an experienced dance coach for secondary, collegiate, and semi-professional venues. Miss Martin is also the team coordinator for Hampton University's Ebony Fire Dance Team.
Mr. Martin Miles, Director of Financial Aid at Hampton University. He is responsible for campus-wide leadership, coordination, management, and administration of federal, state, and institutional financial programs. Mr. Martin has many years of judging pageants for which he has much appreciation and esteem. Mr. Martin Miles, thank you.
Next, we have Attorney Sylvia Rose. Attorney Rose currently serves as Interim Dean of the James T. George School of Business at Hampton University. She is licensed to practice law in Virginia, New Jersey, and Pennsylvania, and has also practiced sports and entertainment law throughout her career. A former Miss Hampton University and experienced in judging pageants, Attorney Rose is committed to the Miss Hampton University pageant and contestants.
Now, let us meet Mr. Charles Stewart Tate. Mr. Charles Stewart Tate, formerly an administrator for Virginia Beach City Schools, is university supervisor in the Office of Clinical Experience for the Hampton University Department of Education. An experienced pageant judge, Mr. Tate is an avid supporter of the Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant and his goal to select an exceptional ambassador for the university. Mr. Charles Stewart Tate, thank you.
And last but not least, we have Dr. Jairus Louise Taylor. Dr. Jairus Louise Taylor currently serves as the director of the William R. Harvey Leadership Institute at Hampton University. Previously, Dr. Taylor served as the Deputy Assistant Secretary of the United States Air Force during the presidency of Barack Obama. He is an alumnus whose community service is exemplified through his support of the Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant. His expertise and commitment are welcomed.
We'd also like to thank Ms. Kelsey Reisinger and Mr. Malcolm Hines, CPA, for auditing tonight's pageant.
Now, let us meet up close the lovely contestants who are competing for the job as Miss Hampton University.
Contestant number one, Anasia Bailey.
Hi, my name is Anasia Bailey. I am from Petersburg, home of Pocahontas Island Black History Museum in Virginia. And my platform is five, fashionably loving yourself. Through fashion, you can build confidence and discover self-expression in your choice of clothing.
Contestant number two, Keandra Howard.
Keandra Howard, from Jacksonville, Florida. My platform is Empowered Women Empower Women, meaning that all women should be uplifting and empowering to one another around them, no matter the race, shape, size, or differences. I want nothing but young, beautiful, intelligent young girls to know that they can be an unapologetic version of themselves and strive for the best. Thank you.
Contestant number three, Julianne Jamont.
Good evening, Hampton University. I am Julianne Elizabeth Jamont.
a graduating senior, international studies major, criminal justice minor, from the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And my platform is Note to Self, influencing students to put their mental health first. Thank you.
Contestant number 4, Angelica Johnson.
My name is Angelica Johnson, a graduating senior, education major, hailing from Delaware. The first state. My platform is TBT, teaching beyond the textbook, increasing community engagement while providing educational opportunities for all outside the classroom.
Contestant number 5, Olivia Johnson.
Greetings, Hampton University students, faculty, and staff. I am Olivia Noel Mengesha Johnson, a senior strategic communications major, political science minor from the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. And my platform is, it is okay not to be okay, focusing on the importance of mental health within the African American community.
Contestant number 6, Kayla Jordan.
Hello to my home by the sea. My name is Kayla Mariah Jordan. I am a graduating senior, health science, policy administration major from Briscoe, Texas. My platform is Get Up, encouraging all to be the pilots of their mental and physical health, as well as their overall dreams. Thank you.
Contestant number 7, Christian Peterson.
Hello, Hampton University. My name is Christian Peterson, a senior business management major from Columbia, South Carolina. My platform is Raising Excellence in African American Leaders, with a mission to enhance leadership skills and cultivate excellence through the preparation of college and the workforce.
Contestant number 8, Laren Turner.
Good evening. My name is Laren Turner, a senior cellular molecular biology major from Houston, Texas. And my platform is The Infinity Project, because the possibilities for young scientists are endless. Thank you.
What radiant and interesting contestants. The winner of this pageant will receive a $1,500 scholarship as well as the title of Miss Hampton University. Although the first, second, third, and fourth runner-ups will also receive a scholarship as well. The first runner-up will receive a scholarship of $1,000. The second runner-up will receive a scholarship of $750. The third runner-up will receive a scholarship of $500. And the fourth runner-up will receive a scholarship of $250.
Now, there are 4 components of the pageant that will be judged: talent, on-stage questions, evening wear, and private interviews. Private interviews, where 25% have been conducted. The private interviews provided judges an opportunity to get insight into the contestant's attributes to fulfill the Miss Hampton University position, her commitment to her platform, and her ability to express her beliefs and knowledge of the world around her.
And now for my personal favorite component of tonight, talent. The talent component is worth 40% of each contestant's overall score. Judges will look for evidence of each contestant's preparatory and performance skills, choice of talent to be displayed, stage presence, personality, interpretive ability, technical skills, and how enjoyable each performance is. Let's enjoy watching and hearing the exceptional talents of our beautiful contestants.
Contestant number 1, Anasia Bailey.
Woke up this morning, heart was beating on my chest, so excited, realizing that you weren't here to judge me, no one to impress. I decided that I liked it. I'm moving on, I'm putting on my favorite dress, the one you hated, said I look naked in. That's your opinion about it, I'm feeling my best, I won't hide it. And besides that, look how the sun rises without her asking, shining with so much passion, light just for us to bask in. Love shouldn't be for our keeping, I'll celebrate my freedom.
Contestant number two, Keandra Howard.
When I count all my blessings, I can't even be said any more. Can't even be said any more.
Contestant number three, Julianne Jamott.
Contestant number four, Angelica Johnson.
People are talking about it. We will just stand here in silence and stop the fire from rising. Whoa, people, don't you be afraid. So many innocents slain. This is an era for change.
Contestant number five, Olivia Johnson.
There is someone here inside. Someone I thought had died so long ago. I'm screaming out for my dreams to be heard. They will not be pushed aside or turned into your own, or cause you won't listen. I am alone at a crossroads, and I'm not at home in my own home. And I've tried and tried to say what's on my mind. You should have known. Oh, and now I'm done believing you. You don't know what I'm feeling. I'm more than what you made of me. I fought the voice you think you gave to me. And now I've gotta find my own. And now I've gotta find. And now I've gotta find my own. My own.
Contestant number 6, Kayla Jordan.
Look at me. Look. Better than I am, but I need you. I need a hand. All of my life I've been fooled. Who said I could do it all alone? How many good friends have I already lost? And how many dark nights have I?
Contestant number 7, Christian Peterson.
Contestant number 8, Laren Turner.
Thank you.
What enjoyable talents. Next, let us view the contestants in a beautiful evening wear. Judges will consider the contestants' poise and confidence in what they have chosen to wear. The evening wear component is worth 20%. Judges will look for posture and carriage in how the contestants exhibit their personal style, attitude, personality, grace, presence, and confidence.
Contestant number one, Anasia Bailey.
Contestant number two, Keandra Howard.
All you got to do is not answer my calls when I'm trying to get through. Keep me wondering why, when all I can do is sigh. I just want to touch you.
Contestant number three, Julianne Jimmott.
Contestant number four, Angelica Johnson.
Contestant number five, Olivia Johnson.
I can't stay away from you too long. Even if I do, I'll always call. Checking on you, make sure you're okay.
Contestant number six, Kayla Jordan.
Brighten up your day. Yeah, yeah. And the point of it all, I love you. Yeah. You know I love you, baby. Oh, oh. My days seem long whenever we're apart.
Contestant number seven, Christian
it's
Peterson.
Like someone has stolen away my heart. You're a major part of my life. And no matter what the storm may bring, I'm fine with you. And the point of it all, I love you.
Contestant number eight, Laren Turner.
I love you.
I love you.
Oh, I love you. Yeah.
each contestant looks so beautiful in their evening wear. Now it is time for the final component of the night, the on-stage question. Questions will be asked by Miss Carmen Mahogany Jackson, the 2019-2020 Miss Hampton University, with responses from our 8 contestants. Judges will evaluate whether each contestant can simply answer the question asked: stage presence, poise, confidence, and relatability. This component is worth 15% of each contestant's overall score.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Carmen Mahogany Jackson, and I currently serve as the 62nd Miss Hampton University. I would like to welcome you all to the onstage portion of tonight's pageant. Introducing contestant number 1, Anasia Bailey.
Good evening, Carmen.
Good evening, Anasia. Could you please pick a number between 1 and 20?
Yes, I pick number 7.
Okay. How would you like to be remembered when you leave Hampton University?
Thank you for that question. How I would like to be remembered leaving Hampton University is prayerfully by being the next Miss Hampton University and a lady that was smart, intelligent, bright, and led her peers with grace, honor, and poise. Thank you.
Thank you, Anasia. Introducing contestant number 2, Keandra Howard. Good evening, Keandra.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please pick a number between 1 and 20?
Number 3.
Give an example in your life how you turned a negative to a positive.
Thank you for that question. An example in my life where I turned a negative into a positive would have to be during this global pandemic. Although it is very rough for anyone in the United States at this moment, just knowing that I can have the moments to be quite aware of my mental health and everyone around me, and to be still be able to check on my friends, is such a blessing and an honor, and that's the positive that I see in it. Thank you.
Thank you. Introducing contestant number 3, Julianne Jamont. Good evening, Julianne.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please choose a number between 1 and 20?
2, please.
How have you positively impacted your community during the time of COVID-19?
Thank you for that question. How I have positively impacted my community is by implementing my platform, Note to Self, influencing students to put their mental health first within my own family and friends, and making sure they put their mental health first during these rough times. Thank you.
Thank you. Introducing contestant number 4, Angelica Johnson. Good evening, Angelica.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please choose a number between 1 and 20?
16.
What are 2 qualities you possess that will make you fit for the role of Miss Hampton University?
Thank you for that question. Qualities that I possess would be my leadership skills and my ability to relate and connect with my peers. With my leadership skills, I'm really passionate about being a leader and also implementing and incorporating different members of our community. I think it's important not just for me to shine, but for everyone around me to shine. Also, I think relatability and being able to relate to my peers and the community is very important. That is why I want to implement my platform, Teaching Beyond the Textbook. We are all teachers and we are all learners. Thank you.
Thank you. Introducing contestant number 5, Olivia Johnson. Good evening, Olivia.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please choose a number between 1 and 20?
Yes, number 7, please.
Someone has already chosen that number. Could you please choose another?
Yes, number 10, please.
Do you think that a college education is necessary to have a successful career?
Thank you for that question. I do not believe that a college education is necessary in order to have a successful career. However, I do believe that a college education can be beneficial in your endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you. Contestant number 6, Kayla Jordan. Good evening, Kayla.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please choose a number between 1 and 20?
Yes, 8, please.
If you were selected to be Miss Hampton University, what are some initiatives and events you plan to execute?
Thank you for that question. My platform, Get Up, encouraging all to be the pilots of their mental and physical health, as well as their overall dreams. I've already hosted numerous events at Hampton University and also outside of Hampton University. I will continue by doing that, by hosting my dance classes and encouraging working out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Contestant number 7, Christian Peterson. Good evening, Christian.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please choose a number between 1 and 20?
15.
Do you believe social media has had a negative or positive impact on your generation?
Thank you for that question. I do believe that social media has had a positive impact on my generation because it allows people from different cultures in different areas to give different opinions about the topics of everyday life in our pop culture. Thank you.
Thank you. Contestant number 8, Laren Turner. Good evening, Laren.
Good evening, Carmen.
Could you please choose a number between 1 and 20?
12.
How do you think technology is affecting your generation's ability to communicate and relate to older generations?
Thank you for that question. I feel that technology has prevented our generation from being able to communicate beyond the screen with older generations, which is something that we need to continue to work on as a generation to strengthen those communication skills. Thank you.
Thank you.
The judges have seen all the components of the competition, but the pageant is not complete unless we hear from the lovely Carmen Jackson, Miss Hampton University 2019-2020.
If it all ends.
sky falls fire. Best believe me, you will see me on the other side.
Strength in her heart, determination in her eyes, and a will to survive resides within her soul. She is you, a warrior, a champion, a fighter, a queen. With love, your 62nd Miss Hampton University.
Wow, 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 I knew I called.
Let's take one more look at all of our amazing contestants who, during this COVID-19 pandemic, have really put their hearts and so much energy into competing in this Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant. They have shown a tremendous amount of flexibility and have led with cooperative spirits, even during these unprecedented times. And honestly, they all deserve to be congratulated.
Contestant number one, Anasia Bailey.
Contestant number two, Keandra Howard.
Contestant number three, Julianne Jamont.
Contestant number four, Angelica Johnson.
Contestant number five, Olivia Johnson.
Contestant number six, Kayla Jordan.
Contestant number seven, Christian Peterson.
Contestant number eight, Lauren Turner.
As we've said before, all of our contestants are amazing, but it is now time to find out which contestant raised the most money for this Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant. The contestant that raised the most money, over $1,000, is... And now for the moment we have all been waiting for. The calculations are in and the judges have made their decision. All of the winners for the Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant are as follows. Fourth runner-up is...
The third runner-up is...
Second runner-up is...
First runner-up is...
And now, the 2020-2021 Miss Hampton University is...
Thank you.